Hello my friends, welcome back to my channel Armored for All, and welcome back to a very quick tech review with Borderlands 3 on the PlayStation 5. And the question is, 60 frames or 120 frames per second? What about HDR? And why I'm always hungry when it is bedtime? Okay, so let's talk about the visual quality from the game. And I'm a little bit disappointed, because what I really don't like is pop-in, draw-ins, and of course motion blur. So we don't have motion blur, or at least we can't disable it if there's something. But what I don't like is stuff like this, where shadows or objects popping in the middle of, yeah, in your face, and it looks really, really awful. The next thing is the same here with shadow. And this happens, by the way, in the visual mode or the performance mode, so there's no difference, okay? So with the draw-in distance or the pop-in distance, let's say like this, it is very bad in my opinion, and yeah, this is one of the parts from the game what I really don't like. Okay, let's talk about 60 versus 120 frames per second. So what is better? In terms of movement, in terms of sharpness from the picture when you move, of course 120 frames per second. So the big downside is, in my opinion right now, this is a very nice sharp picture, 60 frames mode at the moment. So you have minor aliasing, you still have aliasing in the background from further objects like the grass and this lamps where the cable is, something like this, but overall it is, yeah, it is okay. This not the best what I've seen so far, but it is okay. So as soon you change this to the performance mode, and we can show you that we are now here 120 frames per second, we have a very, very low resolution, and I would say it's something like 1080p, and the aliasing or is so visible, it's not aliasing, but I don't know how to describe it, but all these objects where you have edges, of course it is aliasing. It is so awful when you move, and it is, you can really, really see the low resolution here right now. Can you see this? You can't see the flowers anymore. I'll be changing this back, just give me a moment. Now we're back with 60 frames per second. Can you see? It is much better. You still have a little bit of a blurred picture, but it is so much better at the moment. So, my opinion with 60 and 120 hertz in this game, to be very honest, for me, I really love 120 frames per second. I really do. But in this case, I stick with the 60 frames mode. Okay, so we are continuing with HDR, and I did a little bit of testing, and no worries, I don't have any pictures today for you to bother you. But what I found out is that HGRG is doing the trick as always. So what I have done is I calibrated my PlayStation with HGRG and the other time without HGRG, and I couldn't see a difference when after I turned on back on HGRG again, okay? So it doesn't matter, it looks like, but I preferred my way. So I turned a dynamic tone mapping off, calibrated the PlayStation, went into the game, turned HGRG on, of course, and of course changed the internal settings from the PlayStation. So what you can see here now is the light. So HGRG just makes this light brighter, nothing else. Of course, here all the objects what are supposed to be brighter, getting brighter. And what I have changed in the option is just, where is this? Calibrate display. And here we have our HDR. So, and all what you have to do is, I calibrated my PlayStation HDRG, and then you follow the instruction. I did this exactly, it's maximum 800 nits. I changed the UE brightness to 1, because otherwise it's just everything on the user interface is too bright. And I really think this is a very nice HDR effect. Yeah, all the lights getting a little bit brighter. So what dynamic tone mapping, of course, is doing again. It just brightens up the whole picture, and especially with where's my nice moon? There was so a nice moon here. This nice moon. The contrast is really, really great with the blue sky here and the really, really bright stars, which are also slightly changing when you turn on HGIG. Yeah, but very minor. But what is changing, of course, is this yellow, I don't know what this is, yellow lava or whatever. This is getting brighter with HGIG, not very much, but enough to have this great, great contrast effect, what I really, really love, you know what I mean? So when you turn on dynamic tone mapping on, and I did this with calibrating in the PlayStation as well, it will just, blow up your picture, wash out your picture, and the nice contrast is absolutely gone. It is not nice anymore, okay? So my opinion is, or my recommendation is, in terms of HDR, calibrate your PlayStation with HGIG, go into the game, make the settings to according to your screen, in my case 800 nits, and you have a really, really great picture. Okay, so let's talk about the controls. And in another video, I complained a little bit about the adaptive or haptic, adaptive triggers from the PlayStation 4. This was for in Fortnite, and I still stay to my opinion, because in Fortnite, I can't have this, that I have to press or have a resistance here. It doesn't work in games like Fortnite, in my opinion. Here, on the other hand, where it doesn't matter if you, if it takes a little bit longer to shoot or whatever, it is a really nice feature, to be honest, really nice feature. What is a little bit sad that you have a resistance here, but then after that, there is nothing. The whole controller is just vibrating, but you don't have this nice feature from Call of Duty, where you can actually feel when the gun is shooting or firing. So you don't have this here, but doesn't matter, it's still, you have something, and it feels really, really cool. And the other thing is, of course, I like the controller more and more every day, and it looks like sooner or later it will replace the Xbox Elite controller from place number one, can be. The only thing what I'm missing here is, in this game, it looks like that when you, what is the correct term when you, is it, fading? No, it's not fading. You know, when you move around, when you turn left and right. I don't know. Just put it in the comments, please. Because I think there's something like an accelerator. You know, it starts slow and then it goes much, much faster. And I really don't like this. And there's unfortunately no control around this, about the acceleration. So you can change your sensitivity. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Look sensitivity and the ADS sensitivity and the vehicle as well, but nothing about actually the acceleration. And this is a little bit sad, because it shouldn't do this, because I don't, it's just harder for me to aim then, okay? But overall, controls are very, very nice, very direct. Everything is working as expected. No worries. So last but not least, let's talk about the sound. And sound is really, really great in this game. The first 20 minutes or whatever what I played. And even I'm just using my very cheap Logitech speaker set here. The 906, I think was the name. And by the way, I really like it. So for the money what I paid for the speaker, they're really, really great, okay? And for my room, unfortunately, there is not really much space or much more space to put proper speakers in, or larger ones, so unfortunately. But anyway, I'm happy. And the 5.1 digital surround sound is really, really great. So you have all the time the nice music, you have the wind, you have if there's a they're firing at you, you can hear exactly from what direction they're coming. And where I have to go, actually, I have no idea, really. I have really no idea what I have to do, but it doesn't matter. So, sound is, so far as I can say, really, really great. I like the 5.1 support here from this game. And yeah, not sure how does it sound with headphones, but so far, 5.1 is good. Okay, so that's the end from the video already, and yeah, I really can recommend this game if you don't have it on the PlayStation 5. 60 frames per second in, I would say, 4K is really, really great. The graphic is not the best in my opinion, because you have this aliasing, you have pop-ins. From the technical point of view, the graphic is not very good in my opinion. But the overall style from the game and the appearance from the game, it's really, I like the style. That's very important for me. And of course, now we have a nice sunrise here. Where's my moon or whatever? This looks so great. This looks just so great. Okay, anyway, so my recommendation with this game, HGLG on and calibrate the in-game settings from the game according to the manuals. 60 frames per second, because I don't like the aliasing and the much lower resolution from the game. So 60 frames per second and the 4K looks so much better. Sound is okay, so very nice. I can't complain about this. Controls, I'm just missing the acceleration control, but on the other hand, it is fine and you get used to it. Yeah, it's a game for the whole family. Probably not, but it's a good game. And I think at the moment it is also on sales for PlayStation 5. So just check it out and enjoy it. And I thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, so leave a like, leave a comment and subscribe to my channel, because more stuff like this is coming soon. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye.